One of the best parts of attending trade shows is being able to mingle with other creative folks and share ideas and techniques. This one of using alcohol ink on a plate and picking it up with acrylic paint was developed by Sally Lynn McDonald, who shared it at the Creativation 2018 show and then again at NAMPTA in March this year. What you see me demo today is my interpretation of her technique. So a big thanks to Sally Lynn for devising a technique that allows us to use alcohol ink on paper. To help you play along, we'll have alcohol ink on sale at 30% off beginning today, April 4th, 2018. So here are the tools that I'm for the most part going to use consistently today. I have an 8-inch by 10-inch gel press plate. I have two brayers. This 6-inch wide one I'm going to use to apply the inks to this gel press plate. This is devoted to paint, and what I've done, and this is something else that Sally Lynn showed me. So this is one of our 6-inch by 8-inch acrylic stamp mounts that the 5-inch by 7-inch plate works on perfectly. I'm going to use this as a palette. It allows me to print off of this, play around with this, and I've got this paint that's accumulating that I can use for something else. But putting it on this acrylic stamp mount means it's very portable, it's easy to pick up and move. So because the inks dry so quickly, I'm going to add texture after they dry. Now I will say that the first time I attempted this, and I had some fairly pristine bubble wrap at the time, it was clean, just like this. The inks did not pick up in the way that I expected, that I saw happen when Sally Lynn demoed this for me. So what I discovered is that if the thing, whether it's bubble wrap or it's one of our creative art textures, if the thing is already dirty, it helps when it comes time to actually pick the dried alcohol ink up off of the gel press plate. Now I will tell you that even though my creative art textures were dirty, they're pretty smooth, and so it didn't pick up the first time. The way to solve that is to put whatever the thing is in some wet alcohol ink. It doesn't dry so quickly that you can't actually get anything in the wet alcohol ink. So I'm going to show you using one of the creative art textures, and I'm also going to use some bubble wrap. So I'm going to move my palette. It's kind of over here. It's probably going to be out of the shot where you won't see it. Off to the side I have some paper so I can roll off color, and then I have my big brayer off to one side as well so that I can grab it as I need to. So I'm going to start with, this is Amethyst and Pool. Now when you do this, you have a couple of options. You can either brayer these colors all together so that they blend into something else, or you can kind of leave them patchy. I've done it both ways. It really doesn't make any difference. It's just a question of figuring out what you want to do. And as you go along and play, it'll become apparent which you prefer. Sometimes it's cool to have that kind of blocky look of the colors. Again, you'll notice that I'm waiting for these inks to dry. That's what's going to work the best unless I need to dirty my pickup texture tool. So I'm letting this dry, and in fact, I'm going to wave my hand over it. I mean, it's March, and the heat is still running because we're expecting another ginormous snowstorm here in the Northeast tomorrow. But having said that, I am waving to get the alcohol to evaporate, or the solvent base to evaporate out of the ink. That looks pretty good. So I'm going to come in. This is just not great art. I want to show you the technique. I'm going to come in, and I'm going to press the bubble wrap, and you can immediately see the texture that it leaves in there. And then I'm going to come in with one of our creative art textures, and I'm going to press, and I'm going to basically do the same thing. And again, you can see that, and I'm going to just flip this and go this way just because I can. Now, while it is important to let the alcohol ink dry before you texture, you can actually get texture in there while the ink is still wet. That's how you're going to dirty your tool if it comes to that. But before you put paint on here, these really must be dry in order for a pickup print to work, and that's essentially what we're doing, is a pickup print. In order for that to work, what's on the surface of your plate has to be completely dry. Now, the nice thing about alcohol inks, and again, I'm just waving to get the evaporation to keep going. The nice thing about alcohol inks is that this happens pretty quickly. So I'm using Dina Wakely's. This is one of her new colors. It's Buff in the squeezy bottle. Now, your first inclination might be to squeeze the color out here, but depending on the state of your brayer and how much paint it doesn't or doesn't have on it, lots of different factors. Sometimes the brayer will pick up what's on here, and so that's why I have this plate off to the side that I can put color on, and that way I'll come into adding color onto the plate with a brayer that's already got paint on it. Now, in order to effectively pick up a print, it's important that you don't use too much paint. As Sally Lynn says, you want to be able to see what's underneath that paint through it. That's how sheer the layer needs to be. So that looks pretty good. I'm just going to roll the color off. So I'm going to grab a piece of, I'm going to slide this out of the way, grab a piece of printer paper, not put it on the plate very straight for all intents and purposes, and just go ahead and rub this. Now, if you've used too much paint, when you try to pick this up, first of all, you'll get a whole big glob of paint on here, and you won't see the pickup print happen, and you'll see paint left on here. But when this works, and oh my goodness, how fabulous is this? When this works, when you do it correctly, and the key is that thin layer of paint, how awesome is that? You get all of the texture. Now, the thing with alcohol ink is you can't use it on paper. It sucks right into the surface, and you don't get any patterning. You just get kind of really unattractive blobs of color. This technique means you can now use alcohol ink on your journals. This, I said, is printer paper. You can kind of use it on anything you want. Now, one thing that I would like to show you, this is a print that I did. So these are our 6x6, this is a page, rather, from our 6x6 disc-bound journal. This is Strathmore's 400 series, 140-pound cold-pressed watercolor paper. One side is more textured than the other. So this is the side that's more textured, and what I want you to notice, this is the piece that I used to press everything onto the plate. You'll notice that the colors are a little bit brighter here. For whatever reason, when this transfer happens on the side with more texture, you get a look that's a little bit subdued, I guess, is the best way to describe it. When you use the smoother piece, you get a much crisper, more defined print. So depending on what you're trying to do, it's easy to come in and make these backgrounds on your journal pages, and then it's just a question of whatever layers you want to add over the top. After I've been playing a while, I began to wonder what would happen if I brought in metallic mixatives. Now, the regular inks, like the two that you see here, they're transparent. The metallic mixatives are not, and this is gunmetal, which is one of two new colors that, and rose gold, were released by Ranger in January 2018. So what I discovered is, like when you're brayering out the ink to begin with, you can either leave it patchy or you can blend a little bit more. So let me just slide this out of the way for a second. The other thing I want to show you is that you don't have to use a light color as your pickup color. So this is rose gold, and you can see the reflection in there. It's really an interesting look. This is one where I didn't blend it out very much, and then this is another one where I did blend it a little bit more, and you can kind of see the color still glimmering in there. Now, the one thing that you'll notice about both of these is that I picked up with something other than Titan Buff, or excuse me, other than Buff, which is that new Dina Wakely color. This is Peacock, I think it is. Yep, this is Peacock. So where you're going to have transparent places because you've picked up the alcohol ink with something, that background color is going to show through, and your background color is whatever color you pick up with. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to use warm colors this time, excuse me, cool colors this time, and a warm color to pick up. So I'm just going to put out some lettuce, and I'm going to come back to the pool again. And I'm also going to add a little bit of the gunmetal metallic mixative. Now, the thing that I need to bear in mind and that you'll want to think about too is that, and I'm not going to use too much of this because I don't want it to overwhelm, is that whatever color was previously on your brayer is going to get blended in with whatever you're doing. So I'm starting to see some of the purple color in here from the last thing. Now, as long as I don't overblend this, it's not going to get muddy. I'm just going to get some nice, interesting purple colors in there along with the other three. So this time I'll come back, I'm going to use, just waiting for this to dry, you do get a better lift of alcohol ink if this is dry. So what I'm going to do is use another of our Creative Art textures. It's the one with the numbers that I actually like quite a lot, and it works well with this technique. So I'm going to come in and just pat this on, lift it up, and do the same thing here, and then I'm going to turn it around just for fun, so it's going in the opposite direction, because why not? The nice thing about the metallic mixative is mixatives are that they give you a completely different look, but the technique doesn't change. So I'm going to bring my palette in. Now, there's still some buff left on here from the last time. I'm going to actually allow this to mix if it wants to and make a slightly lighter pink color. I'm not worried about that one way or the other. Now, I already can tell that this is probably going to be too much paint, so I'm going to brayer some of it off to the other side. I can't stress enough how important it is that you use less paint. Too much is never a good thing with gel press, but especially when you are trying to pick up like this, it's important that you use a very small amount. Again, I'm going to come back with my paper, go ahead and put this on there, and just rub this for a moment so that I can get the skin that's sitting on the plate, that is the dried alcohol ink, I want to get that to be picked up by that fuchsia paint that I just put on there. Or eggplant, actually. Yes, this new color is called eggplant. Fuchsia is an existing color in Dina's line. All right, here it comes. Now, for whatever reason, I can still see some of the green in here, but the fuchsia has really kind of overwhelmed the other colors. So you'll discover these things as you play. Sometimes the background really does affect things. So this is an example of something else I'm going to show you that kind of failed, but you can see that colors can change depending on what you put over the top of them. I wouldn't consider this a failure. I consider this something to think about for the next time that I want to use light colors. So let's, for the heck of it, come back. I'll do some more of these two colors again. I'm going to leave the gunmetal out this time just to make it easy. And I'll come back with some pool. Now, both of these colors are pretty light. Lettuce is not super dark, and pool is one of the more middling colors of turquoise. If I wanted something really dark, I could go with either the aquamarine color, which is pretty new, or turquoise or patina. Those are much darker colors. So this one, I think I'm going to come to the big bubble wrap once this dries. Again, I'm just trying to get that solvent base to evaporate. Come in here with my big old bubbles. Now, I could do multiple things on top of this, and there's nothing that says that you can't, and you can get some marvelous results that way. I'm just keeping it simple here so that we can get this done and not belabor the point. Now, I can see that this corner is damp. I'm just going to dry it off, primarily because I just want to speed the process along. I wouldn't do that ordinarily, but what I don't want to do is have my paint mix. So I'm going to come back. Now, I am going to do something that I said that I generally don't. Because I still have pink on my palette that's pretty damp, and I know that I'm going to end up with a mix on there, and what I want to do is come back with the Titan Buff. I will show you that you can do it this way, but it requires that you really spread the paint out so that you don't have that brayer touching the alcohol ink any more than absolutely necessary. And obviously, again, you still don't want to use too much, and this is definitely too much, so I'm going to brayer some of that off. I still think that's a little bit too much. So by brayering some of the paint off to another piece of paper, it allows me to thin the layer that's on here out. Grab another sheet of paper and go ahead and print this. Now, maybe you're wondering what I just did, which is, could I pattern that buff color before I pull the pickup print? And I absolutely could, but remember, if you take too much of the paint away, it can't do its job to pick up. Although nothing says you can't try, because who knows what might happen? Who knows what kind of serendipitous discovery might come as a result of that? Ah, see, that's better. When you use a lighter combination of colors of ink, it's important that you stick with something reasonably light so that you, for the pickup color, so that you don't completely overwhelm it. But what I think is interesting is not only did I pick up the color that was here from this group, but I've picked up odd bits of other things that have been accumulating as I've been going along. And that's one of the really nice things that happens. Now, I would never be able to recreate this because I'd never have that same combination of stuff on the plate, but boy, does this produce some really interesting prints. The last thing I want to show you is how to bring stencils into the mix. And by that, I mean I've already got ink that's dry that I've applied texture to sitting here on the plate. So now I want to bring in a stencil to add some additional texture and pattern. When you do this, what I discovered is the state of your stencil can affect the outcome. And let me show you what I mean. So this, you can see that this stencil is, at least by my standards, reasonably clean. When I applied it to the plate and then put some ink through it, you can see that the background got disturbed. It looked just like this, but a lot of the patterning got disturbed, and that's because the alcohol ink clung to the stencil. Conversely, when I used this stencil, which is filthy even by my standards, you can see, and this was the side that was down against the ink in the plate, you can see that virtually nothing stuck here. And I'm almost certain it's because the alcohol did not grab onto whatever is on here, whatever kind of paint. And this is shimmery. I can see it reflecting, so who knows what's on here. But this is the result that I got when I did that. So very, very different. I'm going to go back to the leaf specimen stencil because I kind of like that technique. So again, I'm prepped with my initial layer of alcohol ink. It's been textured. You'll notice that I brought in yet a third plate. This one also is a 5x7. I find that I get better results if I apply the next layer of alcohol ink through the openings of the stencil using a brayer. So I have that ready to go. I'm going to take, and I think that, I'm just trying to remember, I think that this is the side that was against the plate and the alcohol ink. So what I'm going to do is grab a piece of paper and I'm going to press this. I want there to be really good contact between the mylar of the stencil and the surface of the plate, and you'll see that the alcohol is never going to print. That's the whole point. This will not print once it's dry. So I've got really good contact here. What that's going to do is two things. First, it's going to probably pick up some of the patterned ink, the red that's already there. And secondly, it's going to allow, or it's going to disallow creepage. So hopefully I will not see a lot of the turquoise color that I'm going to use through the openings of the stencil. I'm not going to see that creep underneath. So this is, that's not what I want. This is aquamarine, which is another color that was new in January 2018. Now, what I do want to tell you, when I brayered this color out here, while it was still wet on this brayer, I came and I wiped it off, because remember, what is on here will mix with whatever I'm going to put on that, and I need there to be strong contrast. I need there to be a definite difference between the turquoise I'm applying and the color that's already on there. So I'm going to brayer this, and I'm just going to roll the alcohol through the openings of the stencil in various places. Now, I don't have to do everything. I could, but I don't necessarily have to. All right, I think I'm going to put a little bit more down here and just come and see if I can get some smoothed out here a little bit into the opening so I can see those leaves. And now, again, it's the waiting game. I have to let this dry. So while that's happening, I'm just going to slide the other palette out of the way, wave my hand over here. I feel like I'm performing magic waiting for this the solvent base to go ahead and evaporate. I can take this off, and you can see that there certainly was some disturbance in the pattern that was on here. It's not as nearly as obvious the pattern as it was with the bubbles in it. So that, again, I think provides a really interesting look. Now, because, let's see what this is like. I'm going to bring in, it's so much easier when this is on that 6-inch by 8-inch acrylic mount, but I'm going to just come in with my brayer now and pick up some of the buff, and I'm going to start brayering it on here. Again, bearing in mind that a thin layer is always going to be better for this. That might be a touch too thin, so I'm going to put a little bit more out here. Go ahead and get this on. All right, so this looks pretty good. Just going to slide that out of the way and bring in a piece of paper and go ahead and get it on here so I can pull my print. I have found, again, thanks to Sally Lynn for sharing the technique, that this is a really interesting way to use alcohol inks with your gel press plate. It allows you to expand on the use of those supplies, use them on porous surfaces in a way that you certainly never could if you were just using them straight. So off this comes. Oh, and how interesting is that? Look how cool that print is. You can definitely see the leaves. I got less disturbance on this iteration than I did on this one. Now, that might be a factor of a couple of things. I think that I used a lighter color of, or combination of colors of reds on this one, and because my stencil is dirtier for this one than it was on this one, I think I saw less of that, the color already on the plate clinging to the back of the stencil. So you'll factor that in when you're playing with yours, but you see how interesting all of these results can be.